the idea is to help a customer run their infrastructure. Not only will we implement for them, but the idea is to eventually get them to run their own infrastructures. If you're to ask five different people, what is cloud, you're going to get five different definitions. Building a customer's cloud is really based on their requirements. Our job, or my job, is to help them achieve those requirements into a new infrastructure when they're actually used to traditional virtualization. My name is Bill Holgerson. I'm Principal Domain Architect in the cloud space for Red Hat.
Customers come to Red Hat looking for a couple things. One is obviously the open source technology that we sell, but two, they come to us for our expertise and our skills around deploying that technology as part of a solution for them. So my name is Tom Anderson, and I'm the North American Cloud Practice Director for Red Hat's consulting organization. So I have a team of architects and senior consultants that are very experienced around open source technology and specifically Red Hat solutions for cloud. People on my team go to customer sites to help them deploy our software, implement a solution that they can take advantage of.
A lot of times customers know where they want to get to, they just don't know how to get there. Part of our job is to help them get from a mode one to a mode two agile infrastructure. That application transformation will take time. And if we can help them ease that journey, they'll be able to get to the new infrastructure quicker and leverage the new infrastructure while they're still transforming the application set.
When you look at a cloud migration project, it's more than just the technology. There is technology, obviously we have very important technology that we bring to bear, but it really is around the people in the process. The way they've been doing things today need to change if you're going to automate those functions.
We're going to work with the customer on discovering exactly what they want to do, break the requirements down, then we want to put forth a design that'll meet those needs, requirements and tasks. After we've done that, then we'll help them create an implementation plan. Once we've implemented, we want to test run that and ensure that they're going to be able to take this new environment and run it into production.
Instead of having to wait days, weeks, maybe months for the infrastructure that they need to develop and roll out their new applications, those services are now fully automated and provided to them through a self-service catalog. Literally, it's like going to a storefront. They become far more productive. The rate of applications that they can roll out, net new features, keeping that company competitive, goes up immensely. We offer our customers a number of choices in terms of what the level of involvement Red Hat Consulting has. So we have things like a transition management service that allows us to build the environment for the customers and actually run it for a period of time and then transition it over to that customer with mentoring. Mentorship is very important in terms of Red Hat Consulting. We're not kind of building this for us to run it long term. We're trying to enable our customers to run it for themselves.
The idea is to develop something that's unique, very surgical, very accurate, but yet when we leave, they can run that environment.
As part of Red Hat, we have access to world-class engineers. We have access to our world-class customer support team. Together, we take a much more mature solution out to our customers than just hiring a consultant off the street.
I think bringing Red Hat Consulting in brings experiences of many different implementations. It will help them answer questions. It'll also ask questions that they haven't thought about.
Taking a look at our customers, we really are setting them up for the next 5-10 years of their IT infrastructure needs. It really isn't about a 6-month solution. We're providing them a solution with legs.